Okay, and so welcome back to another Vodcast by Mr. Mahan. This Vodcast is going to serve as your resource as to how to balance easy to medium difficulty reactions. So if you remember in class, the skill that we would discuss was this idea of repping our hood, ram hood, what's good. All right, repping our hood. I use that cheesy, funny little joke because actually what we're going to do is create what's called a rep table. And so I say rep your hood because that serves as a reminder to me that we do in fact have three different columns. And if you look, it's an REP columns, rep chart, rep table. The R stands for the reactants, which again, if you remember, is the left side of the equation, hence the R being on the left. E is going to stand for elements. This is where we're going to place our elements. And P stands for products, which are on the right side of the arrow, hence why it's on the right column. So the first thing to do here, ladies and gentlemen, is to go ahead and go forward and fill in the E column. So we always fill in our elements first. And so my first element is, in fact, hydrogen, and my second element is oxygen. And the second step is to go into your reactants and ask yourself, how many of these elements do I have, how many atoms do I have in my reactants? And the trick here is, remember, you always multiply the coefficient times the subscript. And in this case, I have no coefficient yet, so I assume 1. And so 1 times 2 is in fact 2. And so since I have 2 hydrogens in my reactants, I'm going to put a 2. And doing the same analysis for oxygen, turns out that I have 2 oxygens in there as well. I'm going to now slide over to my products. And I look over here at my products, and because this 2 is not outside of any kind of parentheses, this 2 belongs solely to the hydrogen. It has nothing to do with the oxygen. And so I have 2 hydrogen molecules coming out, and I in fact only have 1 oxygen coming out. So now that we have built our rep table, the next step is simply to actually start to work through our rep table. Now that I've built my rep table, my next step is to go through my rep table, and the overall goal is we want the number of atoms in our reactants to equal the number of reactants or number of atoms in our products. And so at first glance, my hydrogen is actually balanced, so I don't want to touch it. When I look at my oxygens, however, I have 2 reactants going in, 2 atoms of oxygen going in my reactants, and only 1 atom of phosphorus coming out. So I've broken the law of conservation of mass, and so I have to fix this. So the question I ask myself, is there a number that I can multiply 1 by in order to make it 2? And the answer, of course, is yes, I can make that 1 become a 2. Now, because I am changing oxygen in my product side of my rep chart, I'm going to go to my oxygen in my products, which is in this case, this molecule here. And since I wanted to multiply by 2, since I multiplied my 1 by 2 to get this 2, I change and I put a coefficient of 2. And the big thing here, ladies and gentlemen, is understanding that the coefficient that you put in here is not necessarily the number you want, but it's the number that you multiplied by. So because I multiplied by 2, I put a coefficient of 2. And that coefficient is going to be distributed to the oxygen to give me my 2 oxygens, which is what I wanted. However, because this 2 is in front of this molecule, it also gets distributed to the hydrogen. So whereas I originally started with 2 molecules of hydrogen coming out, I now have 2 times 2. I actually now have 4 molecules of hydrogen coming out. So by balancing my oxygens, I've actually thrown off my hydrogens. Ugh. Fear not, though. I come back over here and I ask myself, is there a number I can multiply 2 by in order to make it 4? The answer, of course, again, is yes. I can multiply 2 by 2 to get it to be 4. So because I want it to be 4, I write the number that I want, 4, and I ask myself, what did I multiply 2 by to get it to be 4? Since now I'm changing my hydrogen, and I'm now changing it my reactant side, I look at my reactants. Any hydrogen here? Nope. Any hydrogen here? Booyah. Since I multiplied 2 by 2 to get it to be 4, again, I put in the coefficient, the number I multiplied by, which in this case is 2. In doing so, this 2 gets distributed to the hydrogen and gives me those 4 hydrogens in that I wanted. Because this is separated, this hydrogen and oxygen are separated by a plus sign, this 2 does not affect the oxygen Whereas over here, because these were not separated by a plus sign, the 2 gets distributed to both. Since I have 4 hydrogens in, 4 hydrogens out, 2 oxygens in, 2 oxygens out, hydrogen's happy, oxygen's happy, and so I'm done. If I wanted to be technically perfectly correct, I would go in here and write a 1 next to oxygen so that I now have my coefficients for a balanced chemical equation. Last step is to ask yourself, can I reduce my coefficients, this 2, 1, and 2? And I cannot reduce them because of that 1, and therefore I am done. Equation balanced. All right, our next example problem that we're going to work on is aluminum reacting with sulfur, 8 sulfurs to be exact, to produce aluminum sulfide. And so once again, I build my rep chart. I'm going to rep my hood. Again, the first step is to go ahead and fill in the elements, my first element being aluminum, and my second element being sulfur. Again, I fill in my reactants column first, and so I say that I only have 1 aluminum, because 1 times 1 is 1. I'm going to have 8 sulfurs going in, 1 times 8 is 8. I have 2 aluminums coming out, and 3 sulfurs coming out. And so now again, just as I did earlier, I'm going to look at my rep chart and I'm going to try and balance these. Now here comes the first trick, or first tip, if you will, in order to successfully balancing as easy as possible. Anytime I see an odd number, such as this 3, it should draw like a red alert, red alert, red alert. It should draw your attention as to maybe something funky is going on here, and maybe we want to start here. Now normally we would try and make this 3 an even number by maybe doubling it. But the question I really have to ask myself, is there any way I can multiply 3 by a whole number to make it 8? And the answer is no. I then ask myself, is there any way I can multiply this 8 by a whole number to get it to be 3? Again, the answer being no. So what I actually have to do here is refer to the least common factor between 8 and 3, which is going to be 24. And so I'm going to make 24 molecules of sulfur come out. Now again, since I'm changing sulfur in my product side, I find sulfur in my products. Here it is. I ask myself, 3 times what gets me to 24? And in order to get to 24 from 3, I had to multiply by 8. Again, this 8 gets distributed to my sulfur to give me my 24, but this 8 also gets distributed to aluminum, which now changes 2 aluminums coming out to now 16 aluminums coming out. If I come back over here in order to balance out my sulfurs, again I want the least common factor between 8 and 3, which is going to be 24. And so since I'm changing sulfur again, but now in my reactants, I find sulfur in my reactants. Aha, here you are. And I ask myself, 8 times what gets me to be 24? Since I multiply by 3, I put a coefficient of 3. And in doing so, this 3 only gets distributed to the sulfur. Now, sulfur is happy. It's the same number going in as I have coming out. However, my aluminums are not balanced. I ask myself, can I multiply 1 by something to get it to be 16? And the answer is yes, I can multiply 1 by 16 to get it to be 16. So since I'm changing aluminum in my reactants, I go to aluminum in my reactants, and I put a coefficient equal to what I multiplied 1 by to get it to be 16. Now that I have the same number of aluminums going in as I do coming out, sulfur going in as I do coming out, I ask myself, can I simplify 16, 3, and 8? And although it looks like maybe I can, I actually cannot, and so I am done. I hope that this video, this vodcast, has helped you understand how to use your rep chart successfully to solve some of these easy to medium degree problems. I will be creating another vodcast to help us tackle some of the more difficult problems. Thank you for watching and have a great day.